Hello everyone, welcome back to engineering chemistry class. Today we will discuss ion selective electrodes. These electrodes are also called as membrane electrodes or ion sensitive electrodes. These electrodes are fundamentally different from metal electrodes both in design and in principle. In today's class we will discuss what are ion selective electrodes, construction working of glass electrode, its advantages and disadvantages. We will measure the pH of unknown solution using glass electrode. Finally, we will discuss applications. Ion selective electrodes are those electrodes that respond to a particular ions by neglecting other ions in a solution. These electrodes consist of a membrane which is highly selective or responds towards only one type of ions present in a solution by neglecting other ions in a solution. So the selection of membrane plays very important role. In fact, heart and soul of the ion selective electrode is the membrane. This membrane having some characteristics like it must be chemically stable in salt solutions, it should not be polluted by surface active agents, it should possess sufficient mechanical strength and low electrical resistance. One such example is glass electrode, which is sensitive to H+ ions by neglecting other ions in a solution. Now we will discuss its construction and working also. It consists of a long necked glass tube having a bulb at the bottom. This bulb is made up of a special glass called Corning glass, 22% of sodium oxide, 72% of silicon dioxide and remaining percentage of calcium oxide. The bulb is filled with 0.1 molar hydrochloric acid solution. A silver chloride electrode dipped in the solution which provides an electrical contact which acts as internal reference electrode. This glass electrode is sensitive to H+ ions, hence it is called as pH sensitive electrode. The general representation of glass electrode is as shown in the slides. Let us see few advantages. It is simple to operate. It can be used in presence of oxidizing agent as well as reducing agent. It requires less chemicals and quickly it will measure the pH of the given solution also. Attainment of the equilibrium between two solutions is reached very quickly. This glass electrode, whenever not in use, it must be dipped in either HCl solution or in distilled water. By convention, glass electrode is rendered as cathode. The glass electrode is not a reference electrode. Working. As I mentioned just now, whenever glass electrode is not in use, it must be dipped in either distilled water or dilute hydrochloric acid so that the surface becomes wet. The mobility of the hydrogen ions is more in hydrated layer than in dry layer, hence equilibrium attained very quickly. In the first step, the surface of the glass membrane on both the sides get hydrated whenever it is dipped in different concentration solutions. Hydrogen ions get absorbed on the hydrated surface. In the third step, exchange of H+ ions for the low atomic weight of alkali ions taking place in the hydrated regions. As you can see in the reaction, H+ ions in the solution get exchanged with the sodium ions from the membrane. Because of this, a boundary potential exists. We can measure the pH of the given solution also. Let us see few disadvantages of glass electrodes. This glass electrode cannot be used in presence of fluorodyne as it attacks the glass membrane. The bulb of the glass membrane is very small thickness, 0.01 mm to 0.03 mm thickness, and is very delicate to handle. Third, glass electrode cannot be used when the pH of solution above 10, as it introduces alkaline error. As electrode becomes selective towards N+ ions also, it results wrong results. Hence, we can avoid more than pH 10. Now we will measure the pH of unknown solution using glass electrode. Using this setup, this experimental setup activity has two stages. In the first step, we will determine the energy value. In the second step, we will determine the EZ value. The given glass electrode is washed with distilled water and the bulb is carefully wiped with either cotton or tissue paper. Now this glass electrode is dipped in known solution of pH. Let us say pH is equal to 7. This electrode is coupled with saturated gallium electrode using salt beds. Externally it is connected through wire and finally potentiometer or vacuum to voltmeter. The cell representation as shown in the slide. The cell is connected to vacuum to voltmeter or potentiometer and the EMF measured is called as E known. E cell can be calculated by using this relation E cathode minus E anode. On rearranging, we can calculate the EZ value also. We know that EZ value is equal to energy minus 0.0591 pH. As the pH is known, we can calculate the energy value in the first step. In the second step, we will determine the EZ value by dipping the glass electrode in a known pH. Experimental setup is same, but instead of known pH, we are putting unknown pH. Notice the change in the representation of experimental setup. This time we call them as EMF as E unknown because unknown pH is used and we can calculate the EZ value by using this relation. Finally, pH can be calculated by using this value. Energy value from the previous relation, EZ value from second step. Finally, we can calculate the pH of the given solution also. Let us see few applications of ion selective electrode. We can find the amount of potassium, calcium, nitrogen and nitrates even in fertilizers. It helps to find the amount of potassium, sodium, fluorides in blood samples. We can find the concentration of fluoride, chloride ions and carbonated in drinks and juices also. Examination corner. The first question related to definition of ion selective electrode. You have to mention meaning of ion selective electrode, which includes a membrane and two different concentrations. And you have to mention because of membrane, on either side of the membrane, a potential is developed, that you have to mention the definition. And with the help of neat label diagram, you have to explain the construction working of glass electrode. The second question related to determination of pH. As the problem says, first you have to measure the energy value by using pH is equal to known according to problem. And finally, we can calculate the EZ value. We can find the pH of the unknown solution also. Summary. In today's class, we learnt what are ion selective electrode, construction working of glass electrode, its advantages and disadvantages, measurement of pH of unknown solution using glass electrode.